Hi, now you just learn how to encode in order to index later names of people and of places. And now we're talking about dates. Dates seems easy. In reality, they're much more complex than you think. Dates in the humanities particularly can be expressed according to several calendar in several ways. You can say the third Saturday of the month. It is a date. Which date, which month is not very easy to say. Or the Ides of March, change of calendars. The beginning of the 12th century. And again, where is the beginning and when the beginning of the 12th century ends. 12 of April 1245, More Veneto. In different cities in the Middle Age, they have a different way of beginning a calendar. So beginning of the year can be on the 25th of April, 21st of April, or the 1st of January, or the 31st of December, etc., etc. So there is lots of complexity behind the dates. In the humanities, we also have what we call fuzzy dates, which is the one that causes most problem. For instance, when you say the beginning of the 12th century, when does it end? Does it end in 1115 or on the 31st of December of 1115 at exactly midnight, or in 1120s, or somewhere between 1110 and 1120. You see it here, we have problems, and there is no single standardized ways to say when exactly the beginning of the 12th century ends, or the mid of the 14th century, when it is. Computers otherwise requires this kind of precision. And that's why dating is very important, and in the meantime, very difficult. How you standardize a date? First of all, the problem is to find the right format. And we know that different countries in different places do use different way of standardizing. Sometimes you put first the year and then the month and the day. Sometimes you put the day and the month and the year. Sometimes the month, the year, the month, the day and the year. Or sometimes you just give the year. So it is very problematic. The TI, in fact, has several standards for providing a date. There is the ISO, the W3C, and the custom way. For our exercise and for this MOOC, we will only talk about the basic one, which is the W3C version of the date. The TI has an element called date. And they can be used to encode a date in any format. So you can use the element date for the third Saturday of the month. Also, you can use it for 12 of March 2015. So it's a very generic and it is not very specific. But how you can make it specific? You make it more specific by using an attribute. And the attribute is called when. In the when attribute, you provide a standardized date following the standard 4-digit year, -2-digit month, -2-digit day. So you can, if you want to encode 12 March 2015, you would say 2015-03-12. Or again, June. For June, if you want to say June and you know which is the year, you can say 2015 or 2016, -06. So we accept even shorter version of that particular standard. But if you have the three information, they have to be given in the exact order. There is also an attribute called calendar that allows you to specify that you are following a specific calendar. Calendar, the value of calendar is a reference. It is a pointer, meaning that somewhere in a TI header, in particular in an element called calendar desk, you will describe the calendar that has been used in your text. So you can have the Julian calendar, for instance, or you can have a calendar that was used up to 16th century in Florence, etc., etc. So in your TI header, you explain that, you give it an XML ID, and then using the calendar attribute, whenever you have a date, you can point to that, say, this is the calendar I talked to you about in my TI header. Sometimes dates present themselves in ranges. So for instance, here we see the manuscript was copied between the end of the 13th century and the beginning of the 14th century. How would you do that? In different ways. So for instance, you can use the attribute not before and not after. So you can say that the end of the 13th century, you conventionally establish it is 1285, and the beginning of the 14th century is 1315. Notice again that that is my choice of what means the end, the beginning, respectively. You could have chosen 1280 for the end and 1310 for the beginning. Here, there are lots of debates in the scholarly community, and we have no solution for the moment. So you have to decide what it means for you and stick to that. The consistency is very important, consistent at least within your file. Here you see an example. Here we present it with a letter from Flaubert. And in this particular example, we have two possible dates. The editor of this edition, the URL you find at the bottom of the slide, suggests that this letter was written sometimes in 1858 in April, before the 12th of April. But the edition that was published in Les Pléiades, which is a series of books, say that it was actually on the 5th of April, 1858. So the editors couldn't choose which one was correct, so they presented both. How do you encode that? You can encode that by providing two date elements within a date line element, which is a specific element we use for letters, you know, the date line of a letter. So we have here two dates, which we use in the first case, not before the 1st of April 1858, and not after the 12th of April 1858, and the second one that say actually the 5th of April 1858. But notice that both of them have another attribute which is called resp. They give the responsibility. Who is that that has established those dates? And this is the way you do when you provide a date that is not actually inside the text. You take responsibility. You declare who is responsible for this dating. And you give also the a normalized way for that.